Hearing Officer Dennis Bell, counsel. All those in attendance. The current sheriff and any other sheriff has the right to transfer within the agency as both counsel have agreed to today. The sheriff is elected by the citizens of Knox County to run the sheriff's office. The merit board are only to hear those grievances that fall within the specific rules and regulations of the merit council, which this board is aware of. This sheriff and any other sheriff has the right to issue, revoke any county equipment they deem necessary. Basically, it's our position that this is a conversion of government property to be used personally. They have not carried their proof to show that there is any evidence in this record to support what they call a political transfer. That is her opinion. And her attorney's opinion was first showed up in response to my pre-hearing statement. We all have agreed by the proof presented that one sheriff cannot bind the next sheriff. When there is a non-classified, such as Ms. Dooley, yes, he must adhere to what the previous classified employee was getting. And that comes under the merit board. The fact that the first sheriff Hutchinson, made an agreement that was not legal, and the second sheriff put her under the merit system, which was not proper, it was not mean that this sheriff, who was duly elected by the citizens of Montreal, must somehow keep the commitment of Sheriff Hutchinson and Sheriff Jones. Now, I'm not accusing anybody, and anybody on the board of or council or their client of violating the law or the rules. With all due respect, it's our position that they have wrongfully interpreted the rules. They have wrongly interpreted the merit board rules, the Knox County Sheriff's Office, Knox County Sheriff's Office employee rules, the rules of the state of Tennessee, and we'll let the federal government take care of that other stuff. We disrespectfully say that so far, our position that there's been a wrong interpretation. I have faith in this merit board that they will consider the evidence that we presented and come up with the proper interpretation of the rules.
Mr. Prince, I have a question from the council.
Okay.
Does the throwing in a little curve here.
A little curve. Sit back and hill.
Does a burden of proof apply to this council, and if so, what is it?
Technically, I should have made that argument at the conclusion of plaintiff's proof. And I just told my wonderful assistant, oops. And so I guess I'm just going to have to make a closing and argue that they have not carried their burden of proof.
What is the burden? Is it a preponderance? Is it clear and convincing? Is it beyond doubt? What is the burden of proof?
The rules do not address burden of proof.
No, they don't. That's the reason I'm asking, the council member is asking you.
And it shows that they're very intelligent and want to apply the rules. Thank you. Now, here's what we do have, though. According to Paula M. Taylor, Merit Systems Director, Farm Copy of Myers Morton, and another case I had, the Gibson case, which we were able to work out, they must show that what the sheriff did was arbitrary in the interpretation of cause. We have put on proof as to why the sheriff had cause. The employee shall submit, among other, along with the employee's pre-hearing statement, copy of all documents, which they have, other items that the employee contends relevant, which they have. The sheriff's office shall also submit, along with pre-hearing statements, copy of all relevant internal affairs, unit reports and interviews, also shall submit any documents, records, or other items that the sheriff contends are relevant to the disciplinary action appeal. Prior to the hearing, prior to the hearing, the executive director shall provide a copy of both parties' pre-hearing statements and all the items submitted with the statements to each council member, so that each member has the opportunity to review and examine the pre-hearing statements and items prior to the date of hearing, which we have both done. A copy of each party's pre-hearing statement or attachment shall be delivered or mailed by the party to the other party in advance with the party's filing of items with the executive director, and Paula M. Taylor has done that. He goes further to say that employment of the Knox County Sheriff's Office shall be based on merit. It also says that there's an affirmative defense. If they have to come forward with proof in the record, whether it's honored, whether it's beyond reasonable doubt, whether it's merit and help, they haven't proven anything except for her opinion, his opinion, that it was, quote, politically motivated transfer.
You don't have an opinion as to the burden of proof, what it is.
I have an opinion, but it's meaningless because the merit board rules don't speak to it. And I must go by the merit board.
I didn't know that perhaps it was a case that.
You did for me, Carl. My A student.
But
although she has her master's, she's very high up. You probably leave that up to the chancellor if the court, this honorable tribunal, disagrees with my interpretation of law, which is his interpretation of law. Okay? We leave with that.
Well, counsel's going to be making a decision.
Yes, I'm just trying to hit that curve on it. Okay. So, again, they have not presented any evidence to this record to support that there was a loss of pay. No, we agree that there was not a loss of pay. That's right. We agree that Bernie Lyons took not only that pay, but some other cars, and that was pursuant to the sheriff saying, look, that he is a good sheriff who wants to be everybody to my thing and follow the rules. Other administrations have a difference of their interpretation of those rules. So, I've done my job. I have articulated through evidence my client's position. And I'm not insulting the intelligence of these wise people to go over all the evidence they've heard. They know the law, they know the rules. This request, like the sheriff request, well, videos requested by the media outlets and attorneys were on that call. She had media credentials and was transferred to help. That's not a political transfer. New source must have. That was mission essential. That wasn't a political transfer. There's no evidence of a political transfer. And what Mr. Ryan told us is a misinterpretation of this law. I know they will consider, the American Board will consider these issues, and if I read these right, forgive me, it's the first time I've had the opportunity to do a closing. And I appreciate y'all's attention, appreciate your willingness to put up with me. Glad you're here, so I can be civil. You know me, and I'm emotional. But I am emotional about this issue because I love this family. I love police officers. I took an oath years ago to protect those who serve and protect. And I didn't know there was a good cop and a bad cop. Like any other agency there are, we all have to deal with good and bad. I'm not going to get into my history about my grandfather being superintendent of schools in the 40s. My father, who was a wonderful physician, who was a track coach field for the University of Tennessee for 17